Good evening. Brisbane has escaped major flooding as the river peaked below expected levels. However, there is a new emergency unfolding in the southeast water supply. This is the situation tonight. Flood-contaminated water forces the shutdown of water treatment plants, putting supplies at risk. The flood toll rises to 4 after the death of a 3-year-old boy crushed by a tree. The water is still rising in Bundaberg, where more than 7,000 have been displaced, including all hospital patients. Most of Brisbane and Ipswich spared as rivers peaked well below forecasts. Fears for homes along the Logan River, which is continuing to rise tonight. Now, these pictures were taken at 11 o'clock as the Brisbane River peaked at 2 metres, less than the expected 2.6. That meant many suburbs were spared, but for others, the water rose enough to creep into and under many homes. But authorities are saying no Brisbane homes were inundated in habitable areas. Further peaks are expected tonight and tomorrow, but the water level is not expected to be any higher. And we'll have more on that in a moment. But first, there is an urgent plea tonight for every household in the southeast to conserve water. The amount of swirling mud in the river is 4 times worse than the 2011 floods, and it's shut down Brisbane's 2 major water treatment plants. For the very latest, we go now to Jesse Grayson at EMQ headquarters. And Jesse, what are we being asked to do?
Georgie, we're being told to conserve water for at least the next 48 hours. It's a problem to do with the Mount Crosby treatment plant. All that water that we've had coming through the Bremer and Lockyer valleys over the last 2 days has clogged up the system there. Campbell Newman's calling on Queenslanders to now work together like we did in the 2000 drought to make sure that we don't run out of water.
But if people just keep using water at the normal rate of 450 megalitres a day, there is a problem in some parts of the city that the reservoirs on the hilltops could run dry and that locally people won't have water.
Now, we're being told it's for non-essential things like washing the car and things like that. People can obviously still use drinking water, wash their clothes and have a shower. But it has prompted some supermarkets to start putting water out for the impending rush of people buying drinking water. We're told there will be a slight taste of the water over the next 48 hours. But we are told if we do work together, we can get through this.
Very important message. Thank you. Jesse Grayson at EMQ headquarters.